Today, we're going to talk about the electric car sharing, BlueSG. And this is not a sponsored video, just my most honest opinion. In the recent budget announcement, the government unveiled the Singapore Green Plan 2030. And in it, it actually specified that it would like to build 60,000 EV charging points by 2030 and have 8 EV-ready towns by 2025. So it seems like the push is towards EV vehicles in the near future. And there is about 630,000 private vehicles in Singapore, and that includes vehicles for hire under Grab or Gojek. So 60,000 electric vehicle charging point would amount to be about 10% of the total private vehicle population in Singapore. And that means that by 2030, at least 10% of the total vehicle population would be EV cars. And by 2040, the government will be phasing out ICE vehicles, internal combustion engine vehicles, by then.
So much about statistics, so let's start driving.
BlueSG started back in 2017, the year which I scrapped my car and gave up car ownership. I have been with them since 2017, and in between, I have also joined other car sharing options, but it didn't turn out as well as BlueSG. BlueSG allows me to drive from point A to point B without me having to return to the vehicle to the original location which I first picked it up. And of course, there are other perks like not having to worry about parking or even topping up of petrol, unlike most petrol rental cars.
Well, I do believe you can hear me because it is relatively quiet without a combustion engine running in the background of this car. So it should sound pretty quiet. And to be frank, I'm not really good at talking and driving at the same time. I'm not a person that actually can multitask well. But yeah, I'll give it a try. So today I'm driving to Botanical Garden again. Because I still need to take some more footage, which I missed out previously. So yeah, as you can see, this car is basically a no-frills car. It's a two-door, four-seater hatchback. Although from the outside it looks pretty small, but in actual fact it can comfortably seat 4 person and also have some boot space for a few bags of groceries. This car basically has only two gears, the forward and the reverse. And the pickup is much faster than a normal petrol car. And the maximum speed for this car can go up to around 120, depending on road condition. So all in, it still feels like you are driving, just that you don't really feel the gear shift because there isn't any at all.
As you know that Singapore is not creating energy in a very green manner using natural gas, so some of the skeptics are worried that with the increase of electric vehicles, we will actually add on to the consumption of electricity in Singapore. However, we do have to look at the plan in totality, as the government has been installing more and more solar panels on top of HDB roofs, and they plan to actually generate at least 1.5 gigawatt of electricity from all these solar panels that they are installing. So it seems like electric vehicle is the way to go in Singapore, and if you would like to give it a try, of course I would encourage you to sign up with BlueSG. So I think that's all for today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, click on the subscribe button if you have yet to do so, and turn on the notification bell if you want to receive any notification of future videos I will post on this channel. So I think that's all for now. Until the next video, bye bye.